to understand what this whole third zone of the solar system is like, it makes sense to go to the largest member of that zone. Whether it's Pluto's a planet or a dwarf planet, it's a cool planet, and I think it exceeded expectations. I think everybody thought it would not be just another boring cratered ball like some of the moons of Saturn, for instance. I certainly did not anticipate seeing large mobile deposits of nitrogen ice on the surface, which amongst other things would not only form these big, vast plain Sputnik Plana, which is the size of Oklahoma and Texas combined, but also it operates as a working fluid that actually carves the surface, analogous to the way ice glaciers carve the Earth in the glacial valleys. We had detected water ice from spectroscopic observations of Pluto from the Earth, but we right away, when we begin to see multi-kilometer high mountains and things like that on Pluto, we realized it had to be water ice because the more volatile ices are simply too soft. They can't support that kind of topography. If we went out to some of the other big Kuiper Belt objects, they would probably be just as weird from each other as Triton, Pluto, and Charon are to each other. In order to get to Pluto in anybody's reasonable lifetime, we had to go very fast. So we flew past Pluto at about 15 kilometers a second. So that meant you're really only close enough to Pluto for a few hours to do geology, even with the sophisticated telephoto-type optics such as we had. The reason it takes a long time to get the data back, the transmission rate of our antenna is comparable to a 1990s dial-up modem. That means, for instance, individual pictures take an hour to get back. The spacecraft is on a trajectory to fly very close to yet another Kuiper Belt object. This one's much smaller, maybe 100 times smaller than Pluto, called MU69. It's maybe 30 kilometers across, but we're going to fly very close to it, and we're going to actually take pictures that are 4 times higher resolution at GLSA's approach of it than we took of Pluto. Whether it's Pluto's a planet or a dwarf planet, I think we all agree, having looked at the images, that it certainly carries its weight in planetary diversity and interest.